Hello, and welcome to Software Architecture Monday. My name is Mark Richards. I'm an independent consultant, hands-on software architect, and also the founder of developer2architect.com. In today's lesson number 54, I decided to take a look at some of those books about software architecture that really made a difference in my career as a software architect. Now, I do have a lot of references in developer2architect.com of several books and videos that I think should be on every architect's bookshelf. But what I wanted to do in this lesson was really highlight those books that really made a difference, that had some significance in my career. The first of those books I want to talk about is A Practical Guide to Enterprise Architecture by James McGovern, Scott Ambler, and a whole bunch of other folks. This was the first book I read which really kind of enlightened me about the importance of the soft skills and communications of an architect. And it was a great read in terms of seeing those whole communication aspects and leadership on teams. And so this was one of those first books that really kind of set the stage to realize not only that I should focus on those soft skills, but kind of more how to actually focus on those. And so that was a kind of a special aspect of this book. Another book that was I don't know if influential, but one thing I know has been influential for other people, has been the book 97 Things Every Software Architect Should Know. I actually have four chapters in this book as a contributing author, but this is a fantastic book where when you open up the book, on the left-hand side, when you open up the book, the two pages that are in front of you is the actual kind of tip. And so it doesn't span more than just two pages. And the cool thing is you actually see the headshot of the person giving that tip. And so it really does make a connection with not only the person, but what they really have to say about some tip of software architecture. And so I would highly recommend this book just in terms of these quick tips. As a matter of fact, you'll see a lot of these in here have to do with the soft skills of architecture as well as those whole communication aspects and the process of architecture as well. Kind of turning the page, this was a book I read a long time ago. And although it really doesn't have bearing so much in the software architecture space, it was fairly influential in my career. And this book, titled The Enterprise Architecture as Strategy by Jeannie Ross, Peter Wheel, and David Robertson, really kind of was a defining point actually in my career in terms of kind of understanding sometimes what was actually missing. You see, this is a case study about a particular company and the fact that they tried to launch all these initiatives and continued to fail. And so these folks came in, analyzed their situation, and saw what they were lacking was something they termed a foundation of execution. And when I read that and really understood what they meant by this foundation of execution, which is outlined in this book, it made me think not of companies or IT departments or divisions which are trying to do things, but rather my own personal career. And the fact that in order to be effective in terms of branching out and really understanding a lot of things was actually gaining first that foundation of execution. And by having that grounding, that basic knowledge and framework in place within my own career, I was able to actually launch a lot of new initiatives based on my career. Now, I'm showing it in a career base, but this was a book about enterprise architecture and really how to get those kind of initiative started. I would recommend reading this book, not necessarily for the sake of transforming your IT department, but really reflecting on your own career, on what your personal platform of execution actually is, and focus on building that foundation first before trying to be an expert in all sorts of languages or platforms or technologies or even architecture. Another book that was absolutely influential in my career was The Real Business of IT by Richard Hunter and George Westerman. Now, I've heard Richard Hunter speak. He's a great speaker, about this context. And it's actually somewhat a fun book to read. It's filled with a lot of great anecdotes. But this book, although it's written for CIOs, I like to have my development teams read this book as well. You see, what this book really brings forward is not what we're doing, but really why we're doing it. And too many times, especially in operations or development, and sometimes even architecture, as a matter of fact, we're really not sure why we're directed to do something. And so this book really turns the tables on this to say that what you're not doing, everybody, is drawing diagrams or writing code. No, what you're doing is generating business value. And this book encourages you, especially from CIOs all the way down the chain to operations folks, to really understand the motivation and the reasons why you are doing something. What business value are you generating for your company? And this gives a lot of teams renewed motivation to really understand how they are actually making a difference in their companies by what they're doing every single day. So I highly recommend this book. This was an eye-opener for me in terms of these epiphanies about really finding it more important to understand the why as opposed to the how or what. The last book I really want to talk about in this short lesson is Colin Powell's book, My American Journey. This is his first book. Whenever I get asked, Mark, can you tell me what the best leadership book, kind of those soft skills leadership that I could read? Hands down, I always recommend Colin Powell's first book. This is the best book I've read on how to be an effective leader and how to lead teams. You know, there's a lot of those kind of leadership books and the seven highly effective habits or the seven effective habits of highly successful people and all these kind of books. But this one, through stories and anecdotes about, first of all, the history, recent history of the United States, but also just Colin Powell's journey. You actually understand and see those leadership skills being explained with real scenarios. When Colin Powell chose to deploy troops and when to withdraw troops. These kind of leadership skills and decision-making tips are all introduced in this book, and it is a fantastic read. As a matter of fact, if you go to the very end, it's Colin Powell's, I think it's 10 or 12 tips of leadership, and you can kind of just go to the back and look at those, but that doesn't really serve you very well. By actually reading the book, you actually see how these leadership tips evolved and how effective they actually were. And so this was a really influential book to me in terms of really understanding those core leadership skills and actually how to lead teams. So those are just some of the books. There are some other resources as well. There's a whole bunch of areas where you can get information and collaboration about aspects of architecture. The EA Forum, the Enterprise Architecture Forum, IASA, the Enterprise Architecture Network, and of course, the Center for Advancement of Enterprise Architecture Profession. All these are LinkedIn groups. My favorite one, everybody, is this one right here I circled, the Enterprise Architecture Forum. I would encourage you to join this group. There's a lot of great discussions and questions relating to software architecture that also forms not only enlightenment, but questions you might not think to ask as an architect that other architects are asking in the forum itself about what does everybody think about XYZ? It's like, that's a good question. I never thought about that. In my website, I've got a lot of references to further books. These were just the collection that I found really influential. All the books that you can find on my book references in the website, developertoarchitect.com/books.html, are all very, very good resources in our software architecture. I really just had a drive to highlight those particular books that were really influential for me. And certainly, all of these lessons you can find in Software Architecture Monday, which is located on developertoarchitect.com/lessons, and also where I'm speaking at conferences and also public trainings in my upcoming events portion of the website. So this has been Lesson 54, the Software Architect's Bookshelf, those books that are particularly influential or meaningful within my career specifically. And so this has been Software Architecture Monday. Again, my name is Mark Richards, and thanks for listening.